Susan Kay Quatro, more popularly known as Suzi Quatro, was the first American female bass player to enter the otherwise male-dominated world of rock and roll. It all started in 1974, when Quatro landed the role of Leather Tuscadero in Happy Days. She was a former juvenile delinquent and the sister of Pinky Tuscadero, an old flame of Fonzie. Suzi first appeared as Leather in the season 5 episode titled Fonzie the Rock Entrepreneur. It's said that producer Garry Marshall offered her the role after seeing her poster in her daughter's bedroom. Quatro didn't even audition for the part. Suzi made several appearances in the following seasons and quickly became a household name. Today, she's released 15 studio albums and sold over 50 million copies. In this video, we celebrate this tremendously talented star by taking a closer look at her role in Happy Days and its effect on her career. Facts First presents the surprising truth behind Suzi Quatro of Happy Days. If you think Quatro has solidified her place in rock and roll, click the like button. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell for more videos like this. Quatro's sister's all-female band, The Pleasure Seekers, was quite popular in Detroit. Like countless others, the Quatro sisters were also tremendously impressed and influenced by the Beatles' performance on The Ed Sullivan Show in 1964. In fact, Suzi's older sister, Patty, was so deeply influenced by the performance, she decided to create her own all-female garage rock band, and the Quatro sisters decided to call their band The Pleasure Seekers, after they searched the meaning of the word hedonist, and the dictionary threw at them the phrase a pleasure seeker. While Patty took the name Patty Pleasure, Suzi decided to go with Suzi Soul. The band featured one more Quatro sister, Arlene. The Pleasure Seekers gained much popularity in the Detroit area. The Quatro sisters even played with other famous Detroit locals, including Ted Nugent and Bob Seger. Alone, the Quatro sisters mostly played in cabarets. The Pleasure Seekers recorded 3 singles in total and released one of them with Mercury Records. In 1969, after Arlene left the group and the Quatro sisters broke away from Mercury Records due to professional differences, they changed their band's name to Cradle. Suzi's sister Patty was a member of the incredibly popular all-female rock band, Fanny. In 1971, Suzi Quatro signed a deal with producer Mickey Most and RAK Records and left for the UK. This had a great impact on the future of the Pleasure Seekers and Cradle. After Suzi left for the UK, the eldest Quatro sister joined the famous all-female American rock group, Fanny. The group's original members, DeBure and June Millington, had recently left the band, and thus Patty got the opportunity to replace June on guitar. In 1974, Fanny signed a deal with Casablanca Records to release her final album entitled Rock and Roll Survivors. The first single, called I've Had It, released under this record deal, reached the 79th spot on the Billboard Hot 100. The second song, titled Butter Boy, was written by June Millington and was about Bowie. The song became the band's biggest hit and reached the number 29 spot on the Billboard Hot 100. Unfortunately, by the time the song was released, Fanny had already split. Much later, in 1999, in an interview with Rolling Stone, Bowie called Fanny one of the finest bands of their time. Portugal was the first country to recognize Suzi Quatro's talent. The Quatro sisters formed the Pleasure Seekers in 1964, and Suzi Quatro debuted on TV with Happy Days in 1977. The years between were full of struggle and hard work. Even though extremely talented, Suzi failed to get her talent noticed by Americans. For years, she struggled for her big break in America. However, in 1971, coerced by Michael Quatro, the brother of the Quatro sisters, Mickey Most, the famous European record producer and owner of RAK Records, attended a performance of Cradle. The Pleasure Seekers had become Cradle in 1969, and was mighty impressed by Suzi Quatro. Most had already been looking for a female rock artist who he could train to fill the void that Janis Joplin's death had left in the music industry. Mickey Most took Suzi under his wing and brought her to London with him. In 1972, Suzi Quatro released her first single called Rolling Stone. Quatro's name was misspelt as Suzi Quatro on the initial packaging. More importantly, the song registered no popularity anywhere, except in Portugal, where it went to become number one. She said no to Garry Marshall as well as Elvis Presley. By 1977, Suzi Quatro was a well-known name in the UK. She had already delivered 8 songs that had reached the top 40 in the UK. However, Suzi still craved for recognition in her homeland. Thus, when she was offered the role of Leather Tuscadero on Happy Days by producer Garry Marshall, she readily accepted. Though Suzi only appeared as a guest artist and appeared on a total of 7 episodes, her presence on the screen was immense, and her talent did not go unnoticed. Thus, producer Garry Marshall offered Suzi a spin-off of the series. However, she turned it down because she was more interested in music than TV. Here's another fun fact. Garry Marshall isn't the only legend who Suzi said no to. Suzi Quatro was a huge Elvis fan, so much so that her onstage look was inspired by the leather jumpsuit Elvis had worn for his comeback performance. However, when Elvis's team called her to set up an appointment with Elvis, she refused because she thought she wasn't ready to meet her childhood idol. Unfortunately, Elvis died a year later, and Suzi never got to meet him. She inspired a generation of artists. During the 1990s, both Green Day and Nirvana reached their peak of success and became major influences in transforming music and politics. So most of the 90s record labels, hoping to emulate the success of Green Day and Nirvana, began signing up-and-coming bands with even a bit of punk appeal. One such band that was signed by Mark Robinson of the DC-based Teen Beat Records was Tuscadero, named after Quatro's Happy Days character. The band was greatly inspired by Suzi Quatro and even wrote a song called Leather Idol, which was an ode to her. This American indie rock band isn't the only band or artist that Quatro has inspired. She had a direct influence on Joan Jett of the Runaways, as well as Chrissy Hynde from the Pretenders. In 2007, Katie Tunstall released her album Drastic Fantastic. Tunstall paid homage to Quatro through her album cover, where she is seen dressed like Quatro. She also inspired Tina Weymouth of Talking Heads. Talking Heads was a New York-based rock band that was active between 1975 and 91. Stephen Thomas Erlewine, the famous music critic and senior editor for AllMusic, deemed Talking Heads one of the most acclaimed bands of the 80s. The band combined the elements and sensibilities of art rock, funk, punk, and world music, and pioneered what is today known as new wave music. The band had four members: David Byrne, lead vocalist and guitarist, Chris France, drummer, Tina Weymouth, bassist, and Jerry Harrison, keyboard player and guitarist. While the world is familiar with the music of the Talking Heads, not many people know that Suzi Quatro played a key role in the success of the band. In the documentary film Suzi Q, which was released in 2019, the drummer of Talking Heads, Chris France, is seen telling that when the band's Tina Weymouth was unsure of her capabilities as a bassist, France pulled out a Suzi Quatro record to inspire her. In fact, Tina learned to play bass by imitating Quatro tunes. Sherilyn Fenn of Twin Peaks is her niece. Arlene Quatro of the Pleasure Seekers married Leo Fenn, the manager of the band, who also managed other rock bands, such as Alice Cooper and the Billion Dollar Babies. Arlene retired from her music career after her marriage and instead took on the role of the band's manager. On February 1st, 1965, Arlene and Leo were blessed with a baby girl who they named Sherilyn Fenn. Sherilyn grew up to become an actress and has appeared in several critically acclaimed films, such as Boxing Helena and Wild at Heart. She even made a guest appearance on Friends. She guest starred as Ginger, Chandler's girlfriend with a prosthetic leg, in the episode The One with Phoebe's Ex-Partner. However, Fenn's most famous and memorable character continues to be Audrey Horne, a role she played in the TV series Twin Peaks. As Audrey Horne, a high school femme fatale, Sherilyn created one of the most memorable moments of Twin Peaks when she tied a cherry stem into a knot with her tongue in the episode Realization Time. The scene established Sherilyn as a Gen X Marilyn Monroe. BBC chose her as one of the queens of British pop. In 2009, BBC released a TV series titled Queens of British Pop. The series put its focus on female artists who had witnessed and contributed to some of Britain's defining musical moments. Suzi Quatro joined the likes of Dusty Springfield, Marianne Faithfull, Kate Bush, Suzi Sue, and Sandy Shaw in becoming one of the queens of British pop. As part of the series, Suzi recorded a one-hour-long show where she talked at length about her public persona and her private life, as well as her journey to the character Suzi Quatro. The episode released on March 31st, 2011, and was seen by millions of viewers around the world. Her first record label was against her wearing leather. After Can the Can, released in 1973, Suzi became a mega rock star, almost instantly. She went touring the world and inspired many women with her style. Suzi made women see leather as an incredibly sexy material choice. However, when Suzi was recording the promo for her first record, she appeared for the shot in a leather suit, primarily because she thought being in leather would make it easier for her to jump around and do her thing. However, the record label was strictly against Suzi wearing leather. Fortunately, she refused to bow down to them and went ahead with the shoot in her leather jumpsuit, which eventually became a part of her stage persona. Here's another fun fact. Though the world saw Suzi as a rocker chick and a glamour icon, she never identified herself as being particularly stylish or sexy. In an interview, she said that though she was aware of her good looks, she often felt uneasy and uncomfortable when people talked about her sexy image. Happy Days gave us many talented and memorable artists. The show also regularly worked with musicians and bands to create its opening themes. However, no artist captured the vibe and feel of Happy Days as well as the incredibly talented Suzi Quatro, the bona fide rocker chick and glam pioneer who played Leather Tuscadero. Much like her character, Suzi Quatro will also always forever remain etched in our hearts. Now we'd like to hear from you. When did you discover Suzi Quatro? Do you know her better as an actor or as a rock star? Let us know in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to Facts First for more videos like this.